In this episode, I'm going to talk about Lantern Festival. I will share a diary with you. I wrote it on the Lantern Festival. I will read my diary twice. You're going to listen carefully, see if you can understand. Then I will translate each sentence in the diary. After that, I will talk about some important points and some background. At the end, you will do some exercise. You may find it very useful to improve your Chinese using this method. But before we get into all of that, my name is John from espressochinese.com. Welcome to you if you are new here. Subscribe to the podcast because you get an episode every Sunday. And also share this episode with a friend. And one last thing, go to the description for some of the links, resources for this lesson, along with a link to get my book, Everything You Need to Know About Learning Chinese. Okay, let's start. Do you know how to say Lantern Festival in Chinese? It is 元宵节. 元, second tone, 宵, first tone, 节, second tone. 元宵节. 节 means festival. So what is 元宵? There are two meanings. Number one, 元宵 is the night of the 15th of the first lunar month. That means the 15th day after Chinese New Year. Number two, 元宵 is sweet dumplings made of sticky rice flour for the Lantern Festival. So, 元宵 is the name of a festival and a kind of food we eat at the festival as well. That's interesting.It could be a festival or a food. Have you had 元宵before? I had it exactly on 元宵节. The stuffing is sesame and of course lots of sugar. It is too sweet for me. Anyway, let's listen to my diary first. Here we go, two times.
First time.
Wow.二月十四日又到了，今天是情人节，首先祝大家节日快乐。你知道吗？明天也是一个中国的很重要的节日，那就是元宵节。元宵节是中国新年里的第一个月圆的日子。中国人非常喜欢圆，圆就是团圆，所以第一个月圆的日子非常重要，也非常有意义。这一天，人们会和家人在一起。在一起干什么？当然，可以看电视。还有呢，中国人当然忘不了吃东西了。我们吃元宵，元宵有点像饺子，但是它圆圆的，里面的馅儿很甜。哇哦，我真的希望明天快点来，我要吃元宵。你吃过元宵吗？可以留言告诉我。
Second time.
Wow, 二月十四日又到了。今天是情人节。首先祝大家节日快乐。你知道吗？明天也是一个中国的很重要的节日。那就是元宵节。元宵节是中国新年里的第一个月圆的日子。中国人非常喜欢圆，圆就是团圆，所以第一个月圆的日子非常重要，也非常有意义。这一天， 人们会和家人在一起。在一起干什么？当然，可以看电视。还有呢？中国人当然忘不了吃东西了。我们吃元宵。元宵有点像饺子，但是它圆圆的，里面的馅儿很甜。哇哦，我真的希望明天快点来，我要吃元宵。你吃过元宵吗？可以留言告诉我。Okay, and now the translation. Wow, 2月14日又到了。February 14th is here again. 今天是情人节。Today is Valentine's Day. 首先祝大家节日快乐。First of all, happy Valentine's Day to everyone. 你知道吗? Do you know?明天也是一个中国的很重要的节日。Tomorrow is also a very important festival in China. 那就是元宵节。That is the Lantern Festival. 元宵节是中国新年里的第一个月圆的日子。The Lantern Festival is the first full moon day in the Chinese New Year.中国人非常喜欢圆。Chinese people like round very much. 圆就是团圆。Round stands for reunion. 所以第一个月圆的日子非常重要。So, the day of the first full moon is very important. 也非常有意义 and very meaningful.这一天 on this day, 人们会和家人在一起。People will be with their families. 在一起干什么? What are they doing together? 当然 of course, 可以看电视。People can watch TV. 还有呢? Anything else? 中国人当然忘不了吃东西。Chinese people can't forget to eat. 我们吃元宵。We eat 元宵。元宵有点像饺子。元宵 is a little like dumplings. 但是它圆圆的。But it is round. 里面的馅儿很甜。The feeling is very sweet. Wow. 我真的希望明天快点来。Wow. I really hope tomorrow come a little bit faster. 我要吃元宵。I want to eat 元宵。你吃过元宵吗? Have you ever eaten 元宵?可以留言告诉我。Tell me in the comment. Okay, let's check some useful structures and words. At the beginning, I said, wow, 2月14日又到了。You know, 2月14日, February 14th, 又到了。又 means again, 到了 arrived, arrived again. So 又到了, you can use it for somebody 又到了。For example, John 又到了, John arrived again.In that case, I use for February 14, arrived again, means February 14 is here. 今天是情人节, so today is 情人节。情人 is lover, 节 festival. Lover's festival actually is Valentine's Day, so today is Valentine's Day. 首先 means first, 祝大家节日快乐。祝大家节日快乐。祝 wish 大家 everybody, wish everybody 节日快乐 holiday happy. In Chinese, the sentence order a little different sometimes from English. You know, English, you may say wish you, let's say happy new year, or wish you happy birthday. In Chinese, we say wish you holiday, then happy. For example, wish you new year happy, or wish you Christmas happy, wish you holiday happy. In that case, 祝大家节日快乐 wish you holiday happy. 你知道吗 Do you know? It's a question, right? So, 明天也是一个中国的很重要的节日。明天 tomorrow 也是 also is 一个 one 中国的 Chinese 很重要的 very important 节日 festival、okay? 重要 which means important 重 literally 重 means heavy 要 is want so together something is very heavy you want it kind of get the meaning important 很重要的节日 very important holiday那就是元宵节 So now that 就是 exactly is 元宵节元宵 festival Is that okay to just say 那是元宵节 That is 元宵 festival Lantern festival Yes of course We put 就 to make it stronger to emphasize You know 那就是 kind of that exactly is元宵节 ,OK。元宵节是元宵节 is, to explain what is 元宵节。中国新年礼 you know, 礼 is inside, in, 中国新年礼 in Chinese New Year, 的第一个 the first, 月圆的日子。月 is moon, 圆 is round, moon round together means full moon, so 月圆的 full moon 日子。Day, it's like 天 day. 元宵节是中国新年礼 in Chinese New Year 的第一个 first 月圆的日子 full moon day. 中国人 Chinese people 非常喜欢圆 you know, 非常 like very, very like 圆 圆 is round. We really like round.That's true, you know, in the West, when you eat at a restaurant, your tables are square. But in China, many tables are round. It is easy for people sharing food and talking to each other. We like round. Then, 圆就是团圆. You know, 圆, the round, 就是, again, 就 here means exactly. Exactly is 团圆. 团圆 means reunion.Means people be together. We like 团圆。所以 so 第一个月圆的日子 again 第一个 the first 月圆的日子 full moon day 非常重要 very very remember 重要 important very very important 也非常有意义 also very very 有意义意义 itself means meaning.有 has the meaning means meaningful 非常有意义 very very meaningful 这一天 you know, this one day together is a phrase means on this day 这一天 on this day 人们会和家人在一起 so 会 means will 人们会 people will 和家人在一起 it's a phrase 和 somebody 在一起 meansbe together with somebody 和家人在一起 with family together 家 is home 人 is people home people family 和家人在一起在一起干什么 so be together 干什么干 is a spoken way to say 做 to do 干什么 you like 做什么 do what be together we do what 当然 of course 可以看电视You know, 可以 means okay, or can, 看电视 watch TV. Here I drop 我们 actually we can watch TV, right? In that case, Chinese people like to drop subject, especially the subject is very obvious, you know, because we talk about Chinese festival, of course, we Chinese people, we can watch TV, so it's okay to drop we. I just say can watch TV. Actually, we can watch TV or I can watch TV. 还有呢? 还 still you have? 还有呢? Make it a question. 还有呢? Means anything else. 中国人, Chinese people, 当然, remember 当然 means of course, so we of course 忘不了吃东西啦, 忘不了, 忘 means forgot, 不 means no, 忘不了 together means we cannot forget, 忘不了吃东西, eat things, we Chinese people of course cannot forget eating things, right, really like delicious food, 我们 中国人当然忘不了吃东西啦。我们吃元宵, we eat 元宵. Speaking of 吃元宵, I'm thinking actually it seems for every festival, which people has a certain food. Okay, 元宵节, we eat 元宵. Mid-autumn festival, we eat mooncake. Spring festival, we eat dumplings. I wonder if it is also like this in your country. Anyway, let's continue. 元宵有点像饺子. 元宵有点像饺子. 元宵 a little bit 像 like 饺子 dumplings. 元宵 a little bit like dumplings. 但是 but 它圆圆的. 它 means here means 8. The 元宵 8 圆圆的. We just mentioned the 圆, round. 圆圆的, round, round. Why we say round twice? You know, so it is also common. We duplicate the adjective. We say it twice to make it sounds cute, you know. Normally, we don't duplicate adjective, but as soon as you do it, it just sounds cute, lovely. So 圆圆的, it's round, but lovely. You like it, okay? 里面的馅儿, 里面, inside, 馅儿, stuffing, 很甜, very sweet, 里面的馅儿很甜, the stuffing inside is very sweet. In that case, you also can say 甜甜的, right? 甜甜的, sweet, sweet, means it's sweet and you like it. You know, some people may not like sweet thing, they worried about something, so, but if, as long as you say 甜甜的, you say it twice, that means you like it, okay? Wow, 我真的希望, 真的, really, I really hope, 明天, tomorrow, 快点来, 快, you know, fast, 点, is short for 一点, 快点 means a little bit fast, 来 is come, so I really hope tomorrow comes a little bit fast, 明天, 快点来, About this 快点儿, I have a story. Another year, it was 元宵节. I also said to my foreign friend, 元宵节快点来. Yeah, I want the 元宵节 coming faster, but he didn't know the word 元宵节, but he did know the word 小姐, which means miss. So 元宵节 became 元宵姐 in his mind. So he thought I wanted Miss Yuan to come soon. He said to me, who is this Miss Yuan? Mm-hmm. It is very funny, actually. 元宵节, second tone, first tone, second tone. While 元宵节, second tone, third tone, third tone. Anyway, 元宵节, 元宵节. This sounds similar, though. 好, back to the diary. 我要吃元宵, you know, 要 is want, I want to eat 元宵. 你吃过元宵吗? 你吃过元宵吗? We put the 过 after verb to show have you ever done something. 你吃过, you ever eaten 元宵吗? Have you ever eaten 元宵? 可以留言告诉我, 可以, can, again, I dropped 你, 你可以, actually, you can, but it's okay, just say can. You can 留言, leave a message, or leave a comment, 告诉我, and tell me. 你可以留言告诉我。You can leave a message or comment to tell me. Okay, let's listen to the diary one more time. Then we will practice words and structures. Wow, 二月十四日又到了。今天是情人节。首先祝大家节日快乐。你知道吗？明天也是一个中国的很重要的节日，那就是元宵节。元宵节是中国新年里的第一个月圆的日子。中国人非常喜欢圆，圆就是团圆，所以第一个月圆的日子非常重要，也非常有意义。这一天，人们会和家人在一起。在一起干什么？当然，可以看电视。还有呢？中国人当然忘不了吃东西了。我们吃元宵。元宵有点像饺子，但是它圆圆的，里面的馅儿很甜。哇哦，我真的希望明天快点来，我要吃元宵。你吃过元宵吗？可以留言告诉我。The vocab.
It's here again.
又到了。
First of all.
首先。
Wish.
祝。
Happy.
快乐。
Important.
重要。
Lantern festival.
元宵节。
Round.
圆。
Meaningful.
有意义。
Of course.
当然。
Can't forget.
忘不了。
Stuffing.
馅儿。
Leave a message.
留言。Use these words in context. It's here again. 又到了。
The Lantern Festival is here again.
元宵节又到了。
New Year is here again.
新年又到了。
My birthday is here again.
我的生日又到了。Wish, 祝。
Happy birthday to you.
祝你生日快乐。
Wish you a happy new year.
祝你新年快乐。
I wish you a happy lantern festival.
祝你元宵节快乐。Important, 重要。
This meeting is very important.
这个会议很重要。
Lantern Festival is very important.
元宵节很重要。
This matter is not important.
这个事情不重要。Of course, 当然。
Of course I can't forget.
我当然忘不了。
Of course I will go to your house to play.
我当然会去你家玩。
Of course I like to eat yuanxiao.
我当然喜欢吃元宵。And I just want to say again, thank you so much for listening to this podcast. I hope you have found it useful. I write down my daily life and share it with you. You can read them in Chinese, Pinyin, and English. I record them, so you can listen to the MP3 as well. Every week, I choose one of the diaries to talk about here in my podcast. I think it will help a lot in this way. You can read my diary on Facebook, Instagram, or my blog. Check the description for the links. Okay, so again, if you're new here, subscribe to the podcast or to the YouTube channel if you're on YouTube. And if you find it useful, then please send this episode to a friend. Just click that share button and send it to them on WhatsApp or Messenger by text message, or share it on a social media platform. Okay, thank you so much for being here. I will see you next Sunday. Bye for now.